Well, thanks for joining us. This is the prep preview show for the Friday night football games on October 30th. Randy Shaver along with Craig Norcus. And once again, this week's schedule likely going to be altered by COVID cancellations. We record this show on Wednesday, so there's a good chance things will change by Friday. But like everyone involved in making high school football in Minnesota work this fall, we're going to go with the flow. So before we look ahead to Friday and our look at a spotlight game that we like, we're going to look back with Craig, who was at the big Prior Lake Lakeville South game last Friday, which was full of offense. If you like offense, it was your game.
Yeah, I was there, and I have to say, Lakeville South won that game. They were ranked number one. Prior yep. Lake was number three. Prior Lake really hung in there. They impressed me. It was ultimately two second-half turnovers that were they were undoing. But, you know, Lakeville South is definitely deserving of that number one spot. But Prior Lake definitely also deserved that they were right there in their class. They came out and popped them right in the mouth with a 45-yard run by number 23 here. That's Joseph Krause. He had a great game. It was just the Lakeville South offense was ultimately too hard to contain for them. This is going to be a 58-yard touchdown run by Carson Hansen. He had four touchdowns in the game. It was, but again, in the second half, it was ultimately those two fumbles by Prior Lake that cost them. Here you're going to see an incredible strip by Reed Patterson. We're going to show a spotlight of that.
Yep.
Great strip. He got the arm in there, popped the ball out. And the two fumbles that Prior Lake had led directly to Lakeville South touchdowns. This is the icing touchdown in the fourth quarter by Patterson, a 20-yard touchdown run. Prior Lake was still within a score at that point, but ultimately it finished 49-35.
Keep in mind, Riley Mullman did not play in this game. The star tight end, the 6'9", 290-pound blocker for Lakeville South.
Either did Kate Aaron.
And Aaron Holtz, their star defensive lineman, didn't play. And if I'm not mistaken, Carter Hansen is a sophomore running back.
So, yes, I mean, Carson Hansen is a sophomore.
Amazing. So Lakeville South, I mean, they find a way to put all the pieces together to make it work and to beat a quality opponent like Prior Lake.
Well, their offense is a machine. They have scored 165 points
amazing.
In their first three games. That's a stunning 55-point per game average. So I'm going to show you an example of what makes them so hard to contain.
The Cougars run something called a straight T offense. It gets its name from the T that's formed from the center through the quarterback into the three backs in a line in the backfield. There are three factors that make this offense they run so dominant. A powerful offensive line. They have three athletic and very fast running backs, and the misdirection and deception that they run so effectively out of this formation confuses defenses. When we run this play, you're going to see the offensive line block down and completely collapse the defensive front. Let's also look at the action in the backfield. Number 26, Garrett Savard, is going to launch forward and contribute to the blockdown and collapse of the front. As you can see, the entire defensive line and two linebackers are walled off to the left by the action of the play. Now, adjust your eyes to where the ball is. Quarterback Reed Patterson is handing off to number 5, Josh Jacobson, right? Wrong. Number 28, Carson Hansen already has the ball. But can you tell? This has all occurred in the first 1.2 seconds from the snap of the ball. Now, as we run it a little further, we see a Prior Lake defender come up from the second level to plug the hole. It looks like he's got Hansen with the ball, dead to rights, in his sight. But the fake is carried out so well by Jacobson that the defender completely ignores the ball carrier right in front of him and opts to go for the outside runner. You can also see a second defender doing the exact same thing. Meanwhile, Hansen is now already in the clear into the second level, still only 2.5 seconds after the ball has been snapped. One spin move to shake free, and now he's gone. 58 yards to the house. This is what makes the Lakeville South offense so difficult to handle.
And to their credit, they run it to perfection, much like Elk River, who adopted this offense right. a few years ago, Steve Hamilton bringing that offense to Elk River. But Lakeville South, man, they got the horses. And you so eloquently put it that it is really based a lot on deception. When those guys carry out those fakes, it is hard to defend.
And to run that style offense, everybody has to be on the same page, and the execution has to be flawless, or it won't work.
Well, and the other thing about this, and then we'll move on, is the defense also has to know what your keys are. Because I'm sure that those linebackers have all been assigned, you got this guy, you got this guy, you got that guy, because you don't know who's gonna get the ball on any one play.
Right, and if you're playing defense against that, you cannot try to watch the ball or follow the ball.
That's right.
You will absolutely be lost. You have to, like you said, read your keys, or if it's a gap style control defense, you have to pay attention to your gap.
Absolutely.
That's how you beat that.
All right, we're gonna talk about Lakeville South in just a few minutes because they're battling arch rival Lakeville North on Friday, but we wanna spotlight Rosemount and Champlin Park. And Rosemount, very unusual. They played last Friday. They played this Monday, this past Monday against Woodbury, and they're going to play again on Friday
wow.
at Champlin Park. All of this because of COVID. They lost their first two games of the season. They lost 2 weeks of practice to start the year because of COVID. And now Jeff Erdman and company trying to make up for lost time. They won the game against Woodbury on Monday night, 9-7. Let's show you one reason why. Jake Ratzlaff, number 21.
This guy's amazing. I love this video. He was all over the field making hits, making tackles. Last week we talked about he has ability to play high-level hockey or the ability to play high-level football, and we speculated, is he going to go after loose pucks or is he going to go after quarterback ducks?
Right.
After watching this video, I think we have to amend that. I think we have to say he has to decide between a loose puck or acting like a Mack truck.
he really is. Brian Vossen of Lakeville North told me last year when Ratzlaff was a junior, he flat out said to me he is the best defensive football player I've ever seen in Minnesota. And we saw great examples of him.
He's all over the place. And every tackle is like a perfect form tackle.
Exactly.
Driving his guy backwards.
And there's more reasons than just him to get excited
right.
about, because they do have a good running attack with Christian Grasky and a very good all-around football team. But they are going to play three games in basically 7 days, and they're going to play a good Champlin Park team who, coming off a loss to St. Michael Albertville, looking to get back on track.
And three games in 7 days, in my years of covering high school football, I've never seen that. Have you?
Well, they do it close to it in the playoffs. They play on a Wednesday, final week of the regular season, Tuesday to start the playoffs, then a Saturday. Not quite 3-7.
So 3-11.
But this is 2020. And
yeah.
so everything,
right.
they're just trying to get as many games.
They just want to play.
They just want to play. And watch this guy, because this is a guy to watch for Champlin Park. That's Sean Shipman, their star running back. And this is a guy that's going to make life a little bit miserable, I think, for Rosemount's defense.
And here's an 80-yard touchdown in their win against Osseo, 14-7. And, yeah, he's got a lot of skills. And in this St. Michael game here, you're going to see some really impressive runs and plays by him against one of the better teams and defenses in St. Michael. So that'll give you an indication of his ability.
I don't really feel Champlin Park is at the same level they were a year ago. They lost some really key seniors last year when they were the state runner-up in 6A. But they're still a formidable football team. So that's going to be our spotlight game on Friday night at Champlin Park. It's a 7 o'clock start, and Craig will be up there to cover that
and
game.
This is a rematch of last year's 6A state quarterfinal game, a game in which Champlin Park won 34-7.
Should be a really good game. All right, now let's go back and backtrack a minute, because the Battle of Lakeville is happening on Friday. Lakeville North at Lakeville South. Now, North has been kind of jacked around by COVID cancellations. They lost their regularly scheduled first two opponents of the year, and then they lost game three basically because of COVID. So they have had to reshuffle their entire schedule. This may be the first game, if I'm not mistaken, where they will have a full week to prepare for a football team. And obviously, it's against the number one ranked team in 6A.
And if you ever need a full week to prepare for a team, as we just saw by the breakdown of Lakeville South offense, it would be for this game, right? But if I know head coach Brian Vossen of Lakeville North, he will have them ready. And actually, North has had two of the best defenses that I've seen in the last 2 years.
I don't know if this one stacks up.
I'm talking about 2018 and 2019.
But I will say this defense is still decent, and they still can play. And, you know, they've played Lakeville South enough where they might give them some issues in this game on Friday. So this is another one of those games that we're following.
If anyone could figure out the Lakeville South offense, it might be this coaching staff and the North defense.
Right.
And it is one of the great rivalries in high school football now. I mean, dating back to 2005 when the split happened to form the two schools, it's been an amazing and intense rivalry. And North has something to avenge, too. They lost to South last year when they were ranked number one. They were the number one team, lost 34-19 to South. It was their first loss to South in 11 games.
Well, it's going to be a great rematch on Friday night. And this is just one of many really good games on Friday. I want to talk just a little bit, refresh your memory, about why Chaska and Chanhassen are actually going to get a chance to play each other on Friday. This game was scheduled for week two. It got canceled because of COVID. And then they had to scramble to find other opponents. And then it looked like there was no way they're going to be able to play each other. Well, Hopkins and Armstrong were playing both Chaska and Chan, scheduled to play them on this Friday. But they were so nice to cooperate and say, look, we'll play each other, Hopkins and Armstrong, so that Chaska and Chan gets a chance to play their rivalry game. And so that's what's happening. On this Friday night, we're going to get a chance to see them play for the jug.
And we just talked about Lakeville North and Lakeville South being a great rivalry. This one is just as big. And yes, they play for a jug. How cool is that? This video right now is from 2019, last year, in the game that I covered. Look how pumped they are with that thing. I mean, you think more schools are going to play for a jug?
They're going to get a chance to keep that jug on Friday. That's Chaska right there. Let's show you some video of Chaska this year. This has not been the kind of year that we saw from them last year when they were the state 5A champions. They struggled against Armstrong, came back to one. They lost to 4A Power Orono last Friday night. They're still a good football team. It's still going to be a great rivalry game against Cham, but they're not quite at the level that they were a year ago.
Well, the fact that you just mentioned that they may be not quite at the level they were a year ago, I think may have suddenly just made them that good with the chip you just put on their shoulder.
Well, I'm sure they won't mind. I don't think they need any extra motivation to play Chanhassen, but it's going to be a great game. And it's going to be one, again, that we're going to be covering on Friday. This game right here, Moorhead at Rogers, was set up. It was not regularly scheduled. Monticello is hosting a doubleheader on Friday, 4 o'clock, Owatonna against Monticello. And then all of this put together because of COVID. And now Moorhead will take on Rogers. That game is not at Rogers. It should say it's at Monticello at 7 o'clock on Friday night, part of a doubleheader. And Moorhead and Rogers, both undefeated and both ranked in the top five in Class 5A. And then, of course, Prior Lake, St. Michael. That's going to be a great matchup.
That's a
St. Michael, Albertville, very good football team. They're going to be ranked probably number three this week in 6A. And then Minneapolis North playing up about two classes against SMB and this guy, Terrence Kamara, who is off to an unbelievable start, almost 600 yards rushing in three games.
Yeah, and last week we talked about the Minneapolis North quarterback, Zach Yeager. This guy is just another incredible weapon they have on that team. Division I talent, right?
Yeah, and he's definitely a Division I guy. He talks about the film study and his offensive line, how good they are.
I'm trying to see all the mistakes. I'm not trying to see, like, did I break somebody's ankle. I'm trying to see what I could have done to make the play better. It's my O-line, really. It's not just me. My O-line makes the hole, and I take the best of it. Pretty fast, quick to read a hole. So once I see a hole open, I'm hitting and no shoveling my feet too much.
He's going to be one to watch on Friday. This is a 6 o'clock game at Minneapolis North refurbished stadium. This is part of the schedule that Charles Adams put together for this football team, Craig, where he's got Fridley coming on this schedule, which is amazing. Remember, North is 2A. Fridley right. is a power in 4A. SMB has been a power in 4A the last couple of years. North not afraid to move up two classes, at least two classes, to find the best competition, especially because they have such a very good football team this year.
You got to love that. And also, those are both teams that are coming off state championship appearances last year at their level. They both lost in the state championship. But and also, what I love about what Kamara just said right there, he's already wise enough to talk about the importance of his offensive line.
Exactly.
Good move.
Every running back should do that.
Yes.
Before we go, how about a quick shout-out to Harding High School? Ooh. Harding is now 2-0. Harding High School didn't win a football game for 4 years, from 2016 till opening week of this year. Here's some video of their victory last week against Highland Park, in which they won this game 18-10. Okay, Harding, congratulations.
Yes.
I mean, it's been such a long time coming. Otto Krause has done a great job for the Knights to get them to this point. And it'll be fun to see how they finish this year. They get St. Paul Central on Friday. It's a winnable game for Harding, for sure. But congratulations to Harding for getting off to such a good start.
Congratulations. In that 28-game losing streak that they had, the class of 2021 seniors had never had the chance to experience a win.
Yeah.
And now they've got two.
And now they've
got two. I think they suddenly might be addicted to winning.
Well, let's hope so, because years ago, Harding had a very good football program. At least when I started here, they were one of the St. Paul City Powers. So hopefully they're back on track. All right, so that's a look at the big games on Friday, October 3rd. And keep in mind, we are taping this on Wednesday, so COVID could cancel or shift some of these matchups. But we will be here on Friday, 10:15 on CARE for the Prep Sports Extra, 11 o'clock on cable, 11.2 and 11.4. Plus, we're live on YouTube and Facebook and care11.com. Craig is covering the big Champlain Park Rosemount game on Friday. And also a reminder that hot highlight voting continues until 2 o'clock on Friday afternoon on our CARE Facebook page. So if you're into high school football, the weather's going to cooperate. Sounds like it's going to be in the high 40s on Friday, which is pretty good. For a week four in COVID, I think we'll take it.
After last Friday with about a negative, or not negative, I don't want to go that far, but 15-degree wind
felt
chill.
Negative.
Oh, this Friday in the 40s, I'm back in shorts.
It's going to feel like August,
yep.
I think, in a lot of ways. All right, thanks for watching. We do appreciate it. Get out and enjoy some football on Friday night.
Enjoy.